Weaning from mechanical ventilation is the process of transferring the work of breathing from the ventilator to the patient. Some patients can tolerate rapid weaning, which involves an abrupt termination of ventilatory support. Other patients may require gradual removal from the ventilator in order for weaning to be successful. In this video, we will discuss the process of weaning and provide you with an easy-to-follow overview of this topic. So, if you're ready, let's get into it. As previously mentioned, weaning is the process of discontinuing mechanical ventilation and allowing the patient to breathe spontaneously. The ability to wean a patient from the ventilator is dependent on many factors, including the following: the type of respiratory disease that is present, the severity, the patient's age, the presence of comorbidities, and the length of time that they were on the ventilator. For example, a patient who was only on the ventilator for 24 hours is more likely to experience weaning success than a patient who has been on the ventilator for weeks due to a severe respiratory illness. In general, the longer the patient is on the ventilator, the more difficult weaning becomes. But now let's talk about weaning success, which is defined as the patient being able to tolerate spontaneous breathing for 48 hours following extubation without the need for re-intubation. Surgical patients are more likely to experience weaning success than those with a chronic disease. Also, patients who are younger have fewer comorbidities and have a shorter duration of mechanical ventilation are also more likely to experience weaning success. On the other hand, weaning failure is defined as the failure of a spontaneous breathing trial or the need for re-intubation within 48 hours of being removed from mechanical ventilation. The longer the patient is on the ventilator, the greater the risk of weaning failure. Patients with a chronic disease, such as COPD, are more likely to experience weaning failure than those with an acute condition, such as a surgical procedure. There are several pathophysiologic, cardiac, and dietary conditions that can hinder a successful weaning outcome. Some examples include fever, infections, renal failure, sepsis, sleep deprivation, hypertension, hypotension, fluid imbalance, anemia, caloric deficit, acid-base imbalance, and an electrolyte imbalance. Patients with chronic lung diseases are also at an increased risk of weaning failure. So now we need to talk about the weaning criteria. When assessing a patient's readiness to wean from mechanical ventilation, there are some criteria that must be met. The first step for considering weaning requires resolution of the acute phase of the disease that caused mechanical ventilation in the first place. Then the patient must have an adequate cough with manageable secretions and they must be hemodynamically stable. If so, then you can proceed to check the other criteria, which include acceptable ABG results, an acceptable frequency, acceptable tidal volume, vital capacity, minute ventilation, maximum inspiratory pressure or negative inspiratory force, maximum expiratory pressure, rapid shallow breathing index, acceptable oxygenation, acceptable PF ratio, acceptable shunting, acceptable alveolar to arterial oxygen gradient, static compliance, airway resistance, dead space to tidal volume ratio, and the patient must pass the spontaneous breathing trial. If the patient meets these criteria, then extubation can be considered, which involves removing the endotracheal tube from the patient's airway. If you want to support the channel, be sure to like and subscribe. I would greatly appreciate it. And there should be some other helpful videos popping up on your screen right about now that I think you will enjoy. And just a quick reminder, we are not doctors. This video is for informational purposes only. Thank you so much for watching. Have a blessed day. And as always, breathe easy, my friend.